Well, I have a wonderful electronic invention I want you to see. It looks something like this.
Tip number five is calibration. We did touch on this in the last tip, but calibration is so important that we wanted to highlight it and bring it to your attention. Drones have a lot of sensors to maintain flight efficiency, and we want to make sure that these sensors have accurate measurements to fly safely. By calibrating these sensors, we can remove any errors that might have been picked up over time. Essentially, calibration is just needed to make sure your drone is operating exactly as it should. When it comes to calibration, there are four types. Three for your drone and one for your controller. The first type of calibration is position. Now this relates to the compass built within your drone. Position is essentially when the drone is holding itself in the sky, that's the position it's in. If the compass in your drone has an error, then you know it's in that position in the sky, but it might think it's somewhere completely different. By calibrating your compass, it's going to make sure there are no errors in there. The second type of sensor that can be calibrated is the IMU. The inertia measuring unit. This sensor measures the movement of the drone. So on this one, it's easier to show you than it is to explain. So I'll grab the Mavic. So when we calibrate the IMU, we're calibrating the sensor in the drone that tells the drone where level is. So when we calibrate it, we want to make sure that the ground is perfectly level and we don't touch it. That then sets level in the drone as level when you're flying. If you were to calibrate that on a slope, when you were to hover that in the air, your drone is going to fly away because it thinks that that is level. So make sure that you calibrate that on a level ground and you're going to have no issues. Again, this is different for different drones, so make sure you refer to your owner's manual and it's going to tell you exactly how to do that for your system. Third type of calibration is to calibrate your gimbal. All we're doing here is making sure that our gimbal knows where level is. So by making sure that your gimbal is calibrated and level, we're going to end up with level shots and a nice level horizon. So the last type of calibration is on the controller, and it's calibrating our sticks. So when we want to calibrate our sticks on our controller, all we're essentially doing is calibrating it so that when that's at 100% up and 100% down, our drone knows that that's 100% up and that's 100% down. We do this across all of our sticks in all different directions. So all we're doing is making sure if we're flying forward at 100%, our drone is going to do 100% forward in terms of its pitch. This ensures that we've got safe, smooth flying. If our drone thinks that 100% is only a tiny movement, then we're going to be flying at full speed, only just touching the sticks. We don't want that. So by calibrating the sticks on our controller, it's just going to make sure that our drone is going to operate as expected. So as I said at the beginning, all the calibration does is just removes any errors that might have been picked up over time. Just making sure that our sensors in our drone are going to work exactly as we expect them, and then we're going to get no issues whilst we're flying. One thing to be aware of when you're calibrating your compass is that it can be affected by interference or metal around you. So when you're calibrating, make sure that you've got no radio interference, you're not by a big metal structure. Also be aware if there's a lot of concrete around, because concrete often has rebar in, and that can cause interference in your compass. So if you're calibrating your compass, go out into a field somewhere, big open space with nothing around you, calibrate your compass as your manual says, and you'll have no issues.